Today should be shared discuss on one of the most important continuous probability distribution, which is normal distribution or Gaussian distribution. A continuous random variable x said to follow a normal distribution or Gaussian distribution with parameter mu, which is mean, and sigma is a standard deviation of its probability density function is given by 1 upon sigma under root 2 pi exponential of minus x minus mu by sigma whole square divided by 2, and x lies between minus infinity to infinity, where mu is also greater than minus infinity or to less than infinity, but sigma is the standard deviation is always greater than 0. Symbolically, x follows normal distributions, and sometimes we can write x is a random variable follows normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma square, which are two parameters of this continuous distribution. Now, the function of x is logarithmic density function. Because a function is a probability density function, if function of x is always greater than or equal to 0, for x greater than minus infinity to plus infinity or complete range of the x. And second condition is total area under the probability curve under the range minus infinity to infinity is equal to 1. So this normal distribution follows logarithmic density function as if we integrate it with respect to x under the limit minus infinity to infinity, where first we assume x minus mu by 2 sigma equal to t. Integrate by substitution, and in this case if we put t equal to x minus mu by 2 sigma, then dt equal to dx by 2 sigma, and therefore sigma by root 2 sigma, because of x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. So we assume t equal to x minus mu by root 2 sigma, and therefore dx is substituted by dt into under root 2 sigma. And therefore, if we substitute this value into this, exponential of minus t square under root 2 sigma dt. Root 2 sigma cancel by sigma, root 2 cancel. So 1 upon under root 2 pi, under root pi, integration from minus infinity to infinity, exponential of minus t square dt, whose integration we directly use t x vary from minus infinity to infinity, or t vary from minus infinity to plus infinity, then exponential of minus t square, integration of exponential of minus t square with respect to t is equal to always under root pi. So here we put the value of integration, and then we get 1 upon root pi into root pi, which is equal to 1. So given function is a probability density function. Now, standard normal distribution. The normal distribution with mean 1, mean 0 and standard deviation 1 is called standard or simply standard normal distribution, whose density function is given by phi of z equal to 1 upon under root 2 pi exponential of minus z square by 2, where z varies from minus infinity to infinity. We can easily find the standard normal variable z, whose norm mean is 0 and variance is 1, by putting mu equal to 0, sigma equal to 1, and by changing the variable x by z and function f by phi. So if you put in the probability density function of normal distribution, which is now sigma upon under root 2 pi exponential of minus x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square, if you put mu equal to 0, sigma equal to 1, and changing the variable x to z and function to phi. So phi of z equal to 1 upon under root 2 pi exponential of minus x equal to z, mu equal to 0, so z square by sigma equal to 1, so 2, which is standard normal distribution. Where z equal to x minus mu by sigma. If we put z equal to x minus mu by sigma and then simplify it, then we get a normal distribution, standard normal distribution with mean 0 and variance 1. The importance of standard normal variate or normal distribution with mean 0 and 1 is due to the fact that the values of phi of z and integration from 0 to z of phi of z with respect to z are tabulated. And tabulated will we can easily calculate the value of the distribution or probability of the given particular program with help of this table. Normal probability curve. The graph of phi equal to fx or normal density function is a bell-shaped curve and is called normal probability curve for the value of sigma equal to sigma 1 and sigma equal to sigma. This probability curve is symmetric about the mean and the both the tail and it is extended to infinity as mu increases or sigma increases. The properties of normal distribution. Normal distribution has two parameters. First one is the mean mu and second one is standard deviation sigma. Mean mu and standard deviation sigma are two parameters of the normal distribution. In third properties, mean, median and mode are equal in this distribution and in this case all three statistical averages between mean, median and mode are coincide. Area under the normal probability curve. Standard normal probability curve given by a bell-shaped curve. Standard normal variate in this case mean equal to z. So z equal to z. Curve is symmetric about z equal to 0. So area between z equal to plus 1 and minus 1 is equal to 68.27%. Area between the z equal to plus or minus 2z is approx 95.45%. And the last area between z equal to plus minus 3 is 99.73%. So the last result is especially useful in theory of statistical quality control. That it implies if a random variable x normally distributed with mean mu and standard deviation sigma, then almost all the values of x will lie between the limits of mu minus 3 sigma to mu plus 3 sigma or z equal to 3 sigma or plus minus 3 z. Now the mean and variance of normal distribution, which are mu and sigma square, we find by the definition of expected value. If expectation of x in case of continuous distribution is equal to integration from minus infinity to infinity x into probability density function of normal distribution integrating with respect to x. So we put the value of function of x in this integral and then put x minus mu by 2 root 2 sigma into the integral. We get 1 upon under root 2 pi as it is, integration limits minus infinity to infinity as it is. In place of x, if t equal to x minus mu by root 2 sigma, then x equal to t into sigma under root 2 plus mu, exponential of minus t square and dt equal to dx by sigma root 2 is one. Therefore dx equal to sigma root 2 dt and x equal to mu plus sigma under root 2 t, and in this case range of t because of t equal to x minus mu by 2 under root 2, sigma under root 2. So if x equal to minus infinity, then t is also tends to minus infinity, and if x equal to plus infinity or x tends to plus infinity, then t also tends to plus infinity because of mu and sigma are constant and dependent the value of t on x only. So limits given same, minus infinity to infinity, mu plus root 2 sigma t in place of x, exponential of minus t square dt and into sigma under root 2, which is cancelled by sigma and root 2. So outside the constant of integration variable, 1 upon under root 2 by under root 5 n. Now we split the split the function. Mu is the constant, so outside the integration under root pi integration from minus infinity to infinity exponential of minus t square dt plus in second term root 2 is a constant, sigma is constant, so root 2 upon pi into sigma integration from minus infinity to plus infinity, now t is into exponential of minus t square dt. In the first integral, first part of the integral, the value of integration is under root pi. We use in this condition directly, or we can emulate this one by gamma function. So mu upon root pi, integral value of this function is equal to also root pi, so equal to mu. And in second case, limits vary from minus infinity to plus infinity. T into exponential of minus t square dt. Here function is an odd function because of t is an odd function. Exponential of minus t square is even function. So multiplication of even and odd function is an odd function, and therefore second integral should be zero. And so mean of the normal distribution is equal to mu, which is according to our assumptions. Now we find variance of normal distribution, and variance of any random variable x is equal to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. We already find expectation of x, which is equal to mu, and so mu square. Now we find expectation of x square, which is by the definition of expectation minus infinity to infinity x into function of expectation of x square is equal to integration from minus infinity to plus infinity x square function of x dx. Input probability density function value, it is equal to 1 upon sigma under root 2 by exponential of minus x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square, and then integrating with respect to x. The substitutions are remaining same as in previous case. So the integral converted into this form, either mu plus sigma under root 2t is whole square. So we first square the first term and then simplify it. In the first integral, mu square is constant, exponential of minus t square integration from minus infinity to infinity is under root pi, so under root pi cancel by under root pi, and remaining values are mu square. In the second integral is the odd function because of t is odd function and exponential of minus t square even function, so second integral becomes 0 in this case by definite integral property. And in third case, the function is an even function, so first we half the limit and convert into minus infinity to infinity t square exponential of minus t square dt. This is an even function, so first limit becomes half and multiply by 2 because of area remains same in this case, t square exponential of minus t square dt. Now we arrange 2 outside the integral to inside the integral, and t square in place t into exponential of minus t square is it, and remaining take root here. Now we put u equal to t square. So du equal to 2t dt. So in place of 2t dt we put du, in place of t square we put u, and in place of t we put u raised to the power half. T equal to u raised to the power of half, exponential of minus u and du. Now the given integral convert into the form of gamma function. And gamma function defined by gamma n is equal to limit 0 to infinity exponential of minus x, x raised to the power n minus 1 dx. If we compare this integral with the gamma function, we get n equal to 1 by 2 or n equal to 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 minus 1, we can easily find n minus 1 equal to halves, therefore n equal to 3 by 2. So here the value of integral mu square as it is plus 2 sigma square upon under root 5, and integral value is equal to gamma 3 by 2. By the gamma function property, sigma square upon under root 5 as it is, mu square as it is, and gamma is equal to half, gamma half, and value of gamma half equal to under root pi. So under root pi cancel by under root pi, 2 cancel by 2, and we get expectation of x square equal to mu square plus sigma square, which I will explain in the next slide. So expectation of x equal to mu, which is mean, and variance of x equal to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square, means mu square plus sigma square minus mu square, which is equal to sigma square. So these are the simple characteristics of the normal distribution. Now we come to next continuous distribution, which is characteristics chi-square distribution. Chi-square distribution is a square of standard normal variant, and its definition is given by if x1, x2, x3 up to xn are normally distributed independent random variables, then it is known that x1 square plus x2 square plus up to xn square follows a probability distribution and called chi-square distribution. With n degree of freedom, because there are n frequencies. The probability density function of chi square distribution is given by function of chi square is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to the power nu by 2 into under root of nu by 2 into chi square nu by 2 minus 1 exponential of minus chi square by 2, where chi square is always greater than 0, less than infinity, because of the square value never goes to minus infinity. So greater than 0 and less than infinity, and where mu is the degree of the freedom. We can easily derive the probability density function of chi square with the help of moment generating function. So if x1, x2, x3 up to xn are identically independent random variables, and that follows normal distribution. Standard normal variant x minus mu whole square by sigma square then moment generating function mht of z square of chi square, and chi square represented by x1 square was summation of I equal to 1 to n x minus mu by sigma whole square. Here we put x minus or xi minus mu upon sigma I, where mu I is the mean of xi random variable and sigma is the standard deviation of xi random variables. So we can write here first I square equal to summation vary from I equal to 1 to n z I square and z i follows normal distribution with mean 1 and variance with mean 0 and variance 1. Now moment generating function of any random variable mht equal to expected value of exponential of tx. So in this case moment generating function of chi square t is equal to moment generating function of summation of summation vary from I equal to 1 to n and variables are independent and identically distributed. So moment generating function of summation of random variable equal to moment generating function of zi square t whole raised to the power n. So this is equal to moment generating function of zi square, which is equal to zi square exponential of tx. Exponential of tx means exponential, expected value of expectation of tx, where t equal to t is as it is, x equal to zi square t into function of z or phi of z dz. Exponential of zi square t. Now the standard normal variates, so 1 upon under root 2 pi exponential of minus z square by 2 dz, which is equal to 1 upon under root 2 pi as it is, exponential of z square zi square. So zi square common, exponential of minus 1 minus 2t upon 2 zi square dz dzi. And then the limit of the integration minus infinity to plus infinity, minus infinity to plus infinity. So in this case 1 upon under root 2 pi is a constant, so as it is, value of the integral, which is function of exponential of minus z square, so is equal to, if x vary from minus infinity to infinity, exponential of minus x square or a square x dx is equal to root pi by a. So in this case a square equal to 1 minus 2t upon 2, and therefore a equal to 1 minus 2t upon 2 whole raised to the power half, and exponential of minus this integral is equal to under root 5. So root 5 I cancel by root 5, root 2 cancel by root 2, and we get 1 minus 2t whole raised to the power minus half. And therefore moment generating function of chi square t is equal to 1 minus 2t whole raised to the power minus half whole raised to the power m, because of the random variables are identically and independently distributed. So whole power n, and this is the moment generating function of gamma distribution. So by the uniqueness theorem, probability density function of chi square is equal to probability density function of gamma distribution with parameter a equal to half and lambda equal to n by 2. So probability density function of gamma distribution is a raised to the power lambda gamma lambda exponential of minus ax x raised to the power lambda minus 1. So if we put the value of lambda in a, we get the chi square distribution, because a equal to half raised to the power n by 2, so 1 upon 2 raised to the power nu by 2. In this condition we put n equal to nu.
time square in place of random variable 1 raised to the power lambda equal to nu by 2. So nu by 2 minus 1 exponential of minus e equal to half time square. Now properties of chi square distribution. A rough sketch of probability curve of chi square distribution for nu equal to 3 and nu equal to 6 given in the next slide, and by this figure we can find as nu increases or nu decreases, the curve positively skewed. Nu becomes smaller and smaller, the curve is skewed more and more to right side. And if nu increases, then curve becomes symmetrical. And as nu tends to infinity, chi square distribution becomes a normal distribution, because as n nu tends to infinity, curve tends to a normal curve in that case. So nu becomes smaller and smaller, positively in right hand side, and as nu tends to infinity or degree of freedom tends to infinity, then chi square distribution becomes a normal distribution. Uses of chi square distribution. Chi square distribution is used to test the goodness of fit, that is, it is used to judge whether a given sample may be reasonably regarded as a simple sample from a certain hypothetical population. Or second one, it is used to test the independence of attributes, that is, the population is known to have two attributes or trait. Then chi-square distribution is used to test whether the two attributes are associated or independent based on a sample drawn from the population. Chi-square is test of goodness. On the basis of the hypothesis assumed about the population, we find the expected frequencies corresponding to the observed frequency, such that expected frequencies are equal to sum of the expected frequency is equal to sum of the observed frequency. And it is known that chi square is summation of observed minus expected frequency whole square divided by EI, or expected frequency. So follows a chi square distribution with degree of freedom equal to number of independent frequencies. So in this case, loss of one frequency, there are freedom, degree of freedom given n minus 1 in this case. To test the goodness of fit, we have to determine how large a value of chi square we can get, so as to assume the sample is a simple sample from the hypothetical population. The critical value of chi square for new degree of freedom at alpha level of significance, denoted by chi square mu at alpha level of significance, is given by probability of chi square greater than chi square at level of significance alpha is equal to alpha. Critical value of chi square distribution corresponding to few important level of significance: 95% level of significance, 99% or 98% level of significance, and a range of the value v nu are available in the form of a table which is known as chi square table. If calculated chi square value is less than or equal to tabular value, we will expect the null, accept the null hypothesis, which is assume that the given sample is one drawn from the hypothetical population. And that is, we will conclude that the difference between the observed and expected frequency is not significant at alpha percent of level of significance, and if greater than or equal to tabular value, then we will reject the null hypothesis and conclude that the difference is the significant between the observed and expected values. Condition for validity of chi-square test. In this condition, the first is important condition: the number of observations n in the sample must be reasonably large, say n is greater than or equal to 50. Second one, invisible frequency must not be too small, that is, observed frequency is always greater than or equal to 10. In case observed frequency is less than 10, we combine the neighboring frequencies so that the combined frequency greater than or equal to 10. And the last condition is the number of classes n must be neither too small nor too large. That is, n is greater than or equal to 4 and less than 16. Example related to chi square distribution. The following data gave the number of aircraft accidents that occurred during the various days of the week: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Number of accidents are 15 on Monday, Tuesday 19, Wednesday 13, Thursday 12, Friday 16, and Saturday 15. In this question, test whether the accidents are uniformly distributed over the week or not. So first we assume the null hypothesis, which is accident occurs uniformly over the week. First we assume the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis represents neutral position. So we assume accidents occur uniformly over the week. Now total number of accidents: 15 plus 19 plus 13 plus 12 plus 16 plus 15, which is equal to 90. So total number of accidents is equal to 90. Based on null hypothesis H naught, the expected number of the accidents per day is given by expected number of accidents per day of a week is equal to 90 by 6. This is equal to 15. So expected frequency is 15 in each case, and observed frequency is 15, 19, 13, 12, 16, and 15. Now we calculate difference of observed and expected frequency. Observed frequency is 15, 19, 13, 12, 16, and 15. And expected frequency remains same in each for each day, 15. So observed frequency minus expected frequency, or difference of observed and expected frequency is 0. 19 minus 15, 4, 13 minus 15, minus 2, minus 3, 1, and 0. Now, the chi square value is equal to summation of observed frequency minus expected frequency whole square divided by expected frequency. Expected frequency is in each, same in each case, I equal to 1 to 6. So, now we see 1 upon 15 common, observed minus expected value square. So 0 square 0 plus 4 square 16 plus 4 plus 9 plus 1 plus 0. So 16 plus 4 20, 29 and 30. 30 value is equal to 4. So chi square value is equal to 2 in this case, but in the given table, tabular value of the chi square at the 5% level of significance, alpha equal to 0.05, 95% level of significance, tabular value is equal to at nu, because in this case degree of freedom equal to 6 minus 1, n minus 1 is equal to 5. So 5 equal to 111.07, and calculated value is equal to 2. So chi square is greater than also less than chi square at 0.05 or 5% level of significance at nu equal to 5, and therefore on this due to this condition we accept the null hypothesis, which is the accident occurs uniformly over the week.